Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I wanted to talk about some of the bags that I have sold or am currently selling or giving away. Well, actually gave away, past tense. If I still have photos of these bags, I'm going to insert them somewhere in the video, but I just wanted to let you guys know that I have not been hoarding all of these things. I've actually let go of some of them. Initially it was to fund my purchase of my first real Chanel, because you probably know that I have a replica of the classic jumbo, but it actually turned out that I had enough funds to buy one of the Chanels that I wanted, which was an accordion luxe, and so I've sold these just to make space, because really I own too many and I don't really use all of them. So I thought I would go ahead and sell some of them. Some of them have been replaced, I'm not gonna lie. But here we go. I've got it on my phone. Well, this has been sold for a while now. I sold it on the 8th of May. This is the Alma PM. Okay, so I had the Louis Vuitton Alma PM. It's probably one of the first pre-loved designer bags that I owned. And I always had, even when I was like much younger, probably in my mid-20s, when I discovered designers or fashion houses, the first thing that I said to myself was, I'm going to be okay once I own a Louis Vuitton. Louis Vuitton, I think is how you say it, but I don't know, I just hear it from other people. But yeah, I thought that I would be okay and that would be the end of it, and if I buy one, that's it. But you know, when you've got a shopping problem, it's never the last item that you're gonna buy. So anyway, I bought that and I sold it on the 8th of May. I didn't lose any money when I sold this. It's either I broke even or I earned a little bit more when I sold it. Then, remember that Balenciaga giant part-time bag that I found at the Caribbean markets and bought for $50? Yeah, I sold that for $404 on the 30th of June. So that was like... I sold that because, well, let's go back. The Alma PM, I wasn't a big fan of it because I'm not really somebody who likes handheld bags. I prefer them to be crossbody or at least shoulder, because I like my hands free. So I sold that. I use it maybe once or twice. And yeah, I thought, you know what, I'm going to sell it. I'm going to get myself a different Louis Vuitton bag, and I did. I bought the, I'm not sure how you say this, Saumur, S-A-U-M-U-R, in the size 30, because I think that's the smallest size that they come in. That's their PM size. PM? Yeah, PM size. So I bought that, used it a couple of times. It's in storage at the moment. Actually thinking about selling that as well, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. I did purchase that for much more than what I sold the Alma for. I think I sold the Alma for $450 and I bought that Selmor for, I think, $520. Actually, I probably will have it here. Let's find out purchases. Because I did also buy it from eBay. Oh, actually, I bought it for $480, so I paid $30 more than what I sold the Alma PM for. But I do like this one better because it is crossbody. And it still holds quite a bit of things. Although I don't really carry around a lot, which is why I prefer to have a smaller bag. Okay, next thing that I sold, that Balenciaga giant part-time bag that I found at the Caribbean markets. I sold that for $404 after paying only $50 for it at the markets. I did that because I was really annoyed of the fact that the zip only goes one way. So the top zip, there's actually two zips there, they go either direction. But One Direction, ooh, that's a band. Oh no, they broke up. Anyway, the way from the right to the left, I don't know why, but the zip is sort of broken that you have to really be gently pulling, otherwise it won't close. But if you go from the left to the right, it works perfectly. But that sort of like annoyed me. And also it came with a strap that it's made of lambskin. It's a little bit too smooth and slippery that if I put it on my shoulder, and because it's a big bag, it's, I think it's, is it 38 cm wide? I'm not sure, but it's a big bag. It's called a giant, right? So if I put it on my shoulder, it tends to sort of like slip off, and that just annoys me. Again, I'm not somebody who likes to hold bags, especially when they're big and they're full, handheld. No, so I sold that. I wasn't using it. I thought it would go to a better home, and also I knew I was going to make some money out of it. Okay, so I sold that. Then I had the Givenchy 10-hand tote bag, which I swapped. So the cost of the item that I swapped it with was $30, so technically I got this for $30. I sold it for $100. Now this Givenchy is not one of the popular designs. It's a tote, it can be handheld. It's very difficult to actually put it over the shoulder because the handle is quite stiff, so not really something that I wanted to keep. When I got this was very discolored. It was supposed to be sort of like beige, but because of its age and because of it sitting in the sun for being brought to the beach, it sort of like faded and got discolored. So I did a few experiments on it, and if you had been following me on Instagram before, you would have seen that I had recolored this. I might actually have a video of me dyeing this to black and brown. Initially black, brown, and navy, but the navy just didn't look right, so I colored most of it black. Sold that for $100. So again, profit. Then the next thing that I sold was my Burberry small luggage bag. I used this once. It's too big. It's too boxy, I mean. And even at the longest, the strap is not long enough to be worn crossbody. I initially bought it to use it like my camera bag, but I do have my LowPro camera bag for an actual camera bag where it has compartments to take care of my lenses. So I never really ended up using that. I never really ended up using that Burberry bag to carry around as my camera bag. Sold it. It was pretty good for like an overnight bag, but where have I been going? Nowhere! I sold it for $199, which is a loss because I bought it for $320. It's okay. I would rather get the $200 back. Actually, wait. No, I sold it for $227, so I lost $100 there. But I would rather get the $220 back than to have it just sitting in my closet, not being used. It's not even part of my rotation, you know? Then the next thing that I sold is my Chloe Boston bag. The red, beautiful, beautiful bag. I sold it for $220. I bought it for $188 plus shipping. So yeah, I sold it for $220 plus shipping as well. I always ask for shipping. The reason I sold this was the strap on this is so thin, and the bag is quite boxy that if you actually fill the bag, you can see the leather strap stretching, and it also kind of digs into the shoulder when you wear it that way. And again, I have this thing when there is that much space, I feel the need to fill it, and I don't really need to carry that much. Like, unless it's raining, the only thing that I would have in my bag, whatever bag it is, would be my card holder, my phone, hand sanitizer, mask. Nowadays, that's the normal, right? A pack of tissues, and a reusable bag, which fits very well into the smallest bag that I own, which is like it's not a replica, it's more of a dupe. Because it doesn't say Chanel anywhere, but it looks like a Chanel mini, the same size as well. So if all of those things that I need to carry with me fit into the smallest bag that I own. So having a bag that is 3 to 4 times the size of that doesn't really make sense for me at the moment, because I don't really carry a lot of things. So I sold that for a little bit of profit. And then I sold my Prada satchel. Okay. I sold that one because, again, it's not being used. It's a soft cameo color, I think is what it's called. I had a proof of purchase and everything. I bought it for $199 off of somebody on eBay as well. Sold it for $230. Again, a small bit of profit. I don't buy bags to sell them off for profit, to be honest. I buy them because I think I wanted them and I want to use them. And there was a point when I started buying handbags that I wanted them in every color. That's why I have the red Chloe. So I have a blue Kate Spade. That's why I have a green Marc Jacobs and a mustard yellow Tory Burch. But if I'm being honest, I don't use colorful bags. I still gravitate towards my browns, my neutrals, my tans. I still gravitate towards my black and my dark purple. I don't use colorful bags unless it's summer. And even then, I didn't really. Because a lot of my clothes would just go well with some other neutral bags. So, yeah. I was tempted to sell. Well, I did attempt to sell my colorful bags, but nobody bought them. So I recolored my Marc Jacobs, the mint green one, into a dark gray, and I love it so much more now. I have a thing for gray bags with gold hardware. Anyway, so I did have that issue before where I wanted a bag in all the colors, right? And then there came when I bought my first designer bag, okay, the Burberry one, I thought to myself, you know what? I want a bag from every fashion house. So I went out and got a Balenciaga, a Givenchy, Burberry, the Louis Vuitton, Christian Dior, YSL, Chanel, Celine. Who else have I got in there? Loewe. I have 4 Loewe bags. I'm selling one of them, the one that I got for $50 at the Caribbean markets as well. So, yeah, those are the bags that I have sold so far, just in a span of a couple of months, because I really wanted to make space. I did buy 3 bags, 1 YSL, 1 Prada, and 1 Loewe. Yes. Okay. Now, enough of that. Those are the things that I have. Those are the bags that I have sold. Let me know if you want me to do an updated handbag video. I think in my closet now I only have 2 replicas left. That is the Christian Dior book tote in the all leather and the Chanel jumbo. Everything else is authentic. So, yeah, but I am still thinking about letting go of some of those bags. So let me know in the comment section down below if you want me to film a video of the bags that I still plan on or is thinking of letting go. Let it go, let it go. Anyway, and I hope the rambling. I'll see you all again in the next video.